Ciao and welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm with Daniel from Pirelli today, so thank you.
Thank you for having me.
And can you please tell us a little bit more about Pirelli?
Yes, of course. Well, Pirelli is a 150 years old company. We are one of the key players in the tire manufacturing industry. We are actually the exclusive providers of the Formula One tires. And this is because we focus on high value products, especially for the premium prestige sector of the car industry.
That's great. So I see you're a data engineer and we have a data platform here. So can you please start introducing your architecture, please?
Yes, of course. Well, as you mentioned, this architecture represents our data platform in which we are ingesting data from more than 15 factories all around the world. Each one of these factories represent at least 6 source systems, which the whole thing amounts to a total of 4,000 data streams coming into the cloud.
Okay, so that's a huge amount of data that you ingest and collect inside your data platform. And what kind of data do you collect there?
Well, it's mainly related to our production systems in our factories. Most of it is relational data. We do have some non-structured and documental data. As you mentioned, this is a lot of data, so we mainly rely on big data frameworks to process all this. The whole thing starts by the factory sending us the data to our Kafka clusters in a real-time fashion, and then we have this data being consumed by EMR clusters.
Okay, so the big data platform, the big data layer is leveraged on EMR, and what kind of transformation and processing do you do in this step?
Well, actually here we do have a two-layer set of EMR clusters. The very first layer hosts Flink consumers that send this data right to S3 and also to Aurora. Everything real time.
Okay.
Then the second layer is a set of UDI jobs that are taking data from EMR back to EMR. And then this whole thing is written again to S3 and exposed to Redshift via Spectrum.
Okay. So you have, let's say, a very heterogeneous data lake at the end with different data sources for different data as well. And why have you built it like that? So what was your purpose?
Well, Pirelli, from a couple of years now, has engaged in digital transformation stream. And one of the key factors there is the implementation of a big data platform in the cloud, which is going to represent a centralized source for the company data for all of our users so that they can implement the multiple use cases they need.
So it's decentralized access as well for all of your users. And what kind of user, what kind of audience do you have for this data?
Well, we have a bunch of different users wanting to implement different use cases. On one hand, we have our factory developers which implement real-time applications, mainly querying Aurora databases. We also have the data scientists implementing machine learning models and training them directly on S3 data. We also have our data analysts, which are building business intelligence reports directly reading from Redshift or S3 based on the workload that they're using. And finally, we have our external systems querying this whole set of data sources via APIs.
API, okay. So you mentioned you have been working on this in the last few years. So I think you have processed and transferred a huge amount again of data. If you can estimate this amount of data and tell us.
Yeah, well, the last time I checked, we were having 30 terabytes of data. And we expect this to continue to grow as the data ingestion process goes on. And this whole thing has generated over 500 applications distributed across business intelligence reports, applications, and artificial intelligence systems.
Great. So yes, it's a very huge amount of data. So if you would like to share any challenges you may have faced when you were building this very articulated, let's say, data platform.
Well, for me as a data engineer, the biggest challenge was to interact with the business, with the end users, and understand which were their needs and tell them which of these data sources they could use to better fit their needs. Also working with our infrastructure team, a big challenge was to automate and monitor this very complex that platform to ensure data quality and consistency.
Yeah, thank you for sharing this great architecture today and for sharing the challenges you have faced as well. And again, thank you for being here today.
Thank you for the invitation.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture. Ciao.